City against Manchester United, that galaxy of stars who have often disappointed, but who today will dazzle the football.
5 years after the Munich air disaster, Matt Busby had a new Manchester United side, good enough to win the FA Cup. But it was a false dawn. The men that replaced the Babes were different. This wasn't the happy family Matt wanted. There were divisions, player against player, old against new.
I had reason to go and knock the boss's door on three occasions when we were having a nightmare. And I discovered that walking about them, a click here, and a click here, which was not part of United. And sadly, the clicks were all formed by people who'd been brought in from the outside.
We're good players, but we haven't got a good team. You know, they work, but only as for what they wanted, not for what the team wanted. And Matt knew this, and we talked about this, and he got rid of two or three as quickly as he could and changed that pattern.
Busby needed Nobby Stiles. He grew up with the Babes and had learned how to survive in 60s soccer. But most of all, he loved Matt, loved United, and made sure everyone else did too.
He had a great football brain. People forget that about Nobby. Nobby was a great, great reader of the game. I'll tell you something, if you didn't make a mistake when Nobby Stiles was playing in your team, Nobby used to go, I mean, you were afraid to face the little so-and-so.
I used to daydream. I'd daydream. I'd be at Old Trafford and daydream. I've said it before. And I'd be, as the announcer in the teams, and say, and now they're announcing me, Norbert Stiles, you know, number four or something like Hollywood. And that was, and I used to dream it. Fortunately enough, I lived a dream, you know. It was so something that was extra special. But it was just, as I said, going into that club at that time was, that's when George came, you know. That was when George had arrived. George was one of the greats.
This is Best.
Norbert Stiles and Georgie Best were the most unlikely double act. But in their own way, they heralded a new era for United and for football.
What a fine shot, Georgie Best!
Now the good times were back. In 1965, United took the championship in style. But the title didn't really matter. What really mattered was the European Cup. It was why the Babes had died and why Busby came back. It was the Holy Grail. They played Benfica in the quarter-final at Old Trafford. They could only beat them by one goal. Everyone expected them to lose the second leg in Lisbon.
I remember going to the stadium of light, and there was 110,000 people at the game. We drove up to the game, we were getting plenty of abuse, in a nice way from the Portuguese fans. You know, they were very, very nice, in actual fact, the Portuguese fans, they were waving five to us all the way up.
And I always remember, we were going to the stadium, and everybody was doing this, you know. They were all saying five, like, that's what the score's going to be, I suppose, you know.
Benfica kept United waiting, while their golden boy Eusebio was presented with the award for the European Player of the Year.
In the early days, this is foreign to you. You know, the time-wasting, all the different things that they do, you know, no hot water in the shower, you know, all that type of thing, you know, cold dressing room, all the things that they would try and put you off.
We were messing about in the dressing room. Obviously, we're all G'ing each other up, Jimmy and Matt kind of bound, speaking to every player individually, and all G'ing each other up and so on and so forth.
What I used to do is to get a ball against the wall and I'd jam it, tackle, get me, make me feel, you know, tackling, just get myself a feel of the time, slam it against the wall, jam it again, to get a feel of my boots were right and everything. And other lads would knock the ball against the wall, getting a feel or doing a little bit of exercises, loosening up.
You know, I'm kicking the ball about with something, I kicked and there was this big mirror up in the wall, I hit the mirror and I smashed the mirror to smithereens. You'd have thought I'd have shot somebody because everybody in the dressing room went so quiet.
And Harry went berserk. You know. Bad luck. And that was the best bad luck we ever had, like, you know, because... No, we went out again with the team talk. The team talk was, first 20 minutes, we're going to keep it tight. But nobody told George. George just went, and he was unbelievable.
Kaluna. Oh, beautifully intercepted by Best. Great little player, this boy is. This is Law. Because Best is scored. Best has got a goal. United.
It must have been fairly, I suppose, late at night that we were listening, because I'd actually gone to bed to listen to it, and you could just lie there and imagine yourself at the ground. I just closed my eyes and I could see the pitch, I could see play going on, and the pictures were painted by the words of the commentator.
Best again. What a player this boy is. He's got another. 12 minutes gone then. Best surely has now finished the
time. People couldn't believe it. Apparently Busby had told them, now the first 20 minutes, just defend, tuck up and don't give anything away. And this fellow went sprinting off and scored goals, and he sat smoking his pipe or something, and Jimmy Murphy nudged him. He said, I thought you told him to wait 20 minutes. He scored 3 goals. He was 3 up. So people couldn't believe it, like, you know what I mean?
And as each goal went in, and again, I can remember it distinctly, listening to it, I could not believe that it was happening. And the commentator couldn't believe it too.
This is going to be a rout.
It was all so extraordinary. It was like having another ice cream after you just had one. And then, there's no question we're going to win it. We're going to win the European Cup that year.
A lovely one to Charlton. This will be hit number 5, I should think. Oh, what a... That is the pink ribbon on this luscious box of chocolate that Manchester United have given us tonight.
Everybody was saying 5, and it was, but when, on their side, you know, we got the 5, and it was one of the greatest performances, I think, in Europe that we've ever had.
A great performance by Manchester United, and Bobby Charlton had the shirt ripped off his back, and down goes Jackie Crompton.
Extraordinary scenes followed an extraordinary match. Benfica had never lost a European tie at home. Now they had been humiliated. United were supremely confident.
So once we'd done that, we felt then that we were going to win the European Cup, because the teams left in it were nothing at all. And when we got drawn against Partizan Belgrade, hey, this is us.
The Partizan semi-final was strange, actually. I remember I was at a wedding that day, and the match was not on TV live, but the highlights were due to be screened later on in the evening. And the match actually took place in the afternoon, and I didn't want to know the score. I wanted to watch the match as though it were live. And I remember travelling home on the train, and by this time, people knew the score. And I managed to travel from Altrincham to Northwich and tell all the people who I travelled with on the train not to let me know the score. They all knew it. Nobody told me the score. Got home. And I remember sitting there, and it got to about 9:30 before the televised highlights came on. And there was a knock on the door. I opened it, and a mate of mine said the immortal words, I see they've cocked up again.
And Best calls it down the middle. He's going through. Just a chance he can beat the goalkeeper. It's, oh! Oh, my! Lord, with an open goal, hit the crossbar. And my goodness me, Matt having a steward is chewing on there with Jack Crompton and Jimmy Murphy with him. It's a goal! It's a goal! Scored after 65 seconds of the second half. Now the question is, are United going to lose their third semi-final of the Champions Cup?
The answer was yes. Matt had gambled on the fitness of Best and Law, and he had lost. Partizan were better prepared and better organized. In the second leg, they defended well and held on to their lead. United were out. Once again, they'd been found wanting. And it hurt.
They just felt at that time that we went into the game too cocky, you know, too easy. And, you know, when we got beat by them, we were so disappointed.
I was really depressed, and I think Matt was the same. You know, I think he, well, I'm sure he was, because I think he must have thought the same thing, that time was going by, you know, and that was we had a good team that year. We had a great team, you know, and we should have won more than we did.
I think Matt, to be fair, thought that that was his last chance. So I remember speaking to him after the game, and he was a lot lower than we were. I mean, he didn't, as I said, he didn't show emotion a great deal, but, I mean, I felt a great deal of sympathy towards him, because, as I said, he was really down in the dumps. And I said to him at the game, I said, boss, don't worry about it. We'll win the league next year, and we'll win the European Cup the following year. But that was only me saying that to give him a little bit of a lift.
We go in with a different attitude, a different mentality, because it was not easy to play in Europe. We didn't know how to play these teams at times, you know, and it's only a matter... You only get that through years of experience playing against them. How do we go about it? Do we defend a one-goal lead, or do we go out and try and get a second and kill the... You know, it's one of those that... It's like a game of chess.
Tactics had to come into the game, and Europe especially, because playing abroad in Europe, if you think you could go out and play like you played in England, they'll ram three or four past you just like that. And I think teams realised that, and the 60s was the time it started to change.
Wolf McGuinness had worked with the England team that won the World Cup. He was a convert to the coaching manual. But United was supposed to play off the cuff. Go out and enjoy yourselves, Busby said. Not anymore. This was work.
We're an attacking side, basically. You know, you're happier with Bobby Charlton with the ball in their half of the field than you are with Bobby on the edge of our penalty area. You know, because he wasn't a great tackler, and he could have been tackled out of the game so easily.
But suddenly, you know, players were good enough to actually handle these sort of situations. They had to find different ways of doing it. So the tactics changed. We changed different codes. We tried different free kicks, different corner kicks, man marking, which we didn't really do very often, you know, but sometimes if the player was good enough, you'd have to man mark him.
I came in with one idea, which is shown now, from free kicks. We see Dennis Law running over the ball at the Stretford end, the ball being laid into, I think it was David Hurd, who flicks it off, and there's Dennis Law scoring a goal, taking it round the keeper and scoring a goal from a rehearsed free kick.
And it is the first one, and it's Law.
The new style did work. Flair died in the 60s, but United still had Best and Law. Together, the pragmatic and the romantic brought another league championship to Old Trafford. Maybe Paddy Craren had been right after all. Perhaps they would win the European Cup for Matt.